Good morning students, I am Ashmit Prasad and creator of this channel Digital Generation. This channel is regarding chapter wise preparation for both ICSE and CBSE students. I hope you will get best knowledge and explanation from this channel. Today we will discuss the different types of images formed by the concave mirror. The type of image formed by a concave mirror depends upon the position of the object in front of the concave mirror. We will place the object at six different positions and we will also notice the characteristic of the image formed. So let's see the position of the object. First we will place the object within the pole and focus of the concave mirror. So when we place the object within this focus of the concave mirror, then a virtual, erect and magnified image will be formed behind the mirror, and it is virtual because it is upright or it is erect. So the only position when we get virtual image in concave mirror is that when it is placed within the focus or within the focal length of the concave mirror. Suppose the focal length of the concave mirror is 10 cm, so the object must be placed within 10 cm, say 8 cm or less than 10 cm, then only we will get erect, virtual and magnified image of the object in concave mirror. In second case, we will put the object at focus. When we put the object at focus, then we will get highly magnified image which is formed at infinity, which cannot be drawn by the ray diagram. So highly magnified image is formed when the object is placed at focus. Say here the focal length is 10 cm. So when the object is placed at 10 cm, then image will be formed at infinity, which will be real, inverted and highly magnified. In third case, we will put the object between focus and center of curvature, that is between here. When the object is placed between center of curvature and focus, then real, inverted and magnified image will be formed beyond center of curvature, which is greater than the distance of center of curvature. Suppose here the focal length is 10 cm, then its focus is at 10 cm, then center of curvature will be 20 cm. So when the object is placed between focus and center of curvature, means the distance of the object must be less than 20 cm, say 15 cm or 18 cm or less than that of 20 cm, then image will be formed beyond C, which will be greater than 20 cm, say at 25 cm, which will be real, inverted and magnified. In fourth case, we will put the object at center of curvature. When we put the object at center of curvature, then we will get real, inverted image which will be same size as that of the object and will be formed at center of curvature only. So it is the only position of the object when we get real, inverted image and will be same size of the object and will be formed at the same place, that is at center of curvature. Here the focal length is 10 cm, so focus is at 10 cm, so center of curvature will be 20 cm, and hence the object will be placed at 20 cm, and the image will also form at 20 cm. In fifth case, we will place the object beyond center of curvature. When we place an object beyond center of curvature, then an image will be formed between center of curvature and focus, which will be real, inverted and diminished. So the distance of the object must be greater than 20 cm, say here 25 cm or 30 cm, anything greater than 20 cm. So when object is placed beyond center of curvature, that is a distance greater than center of curvature, then a real, inverted and diminished image is formed between focus and center of curvature, that is between 10 cm to 20 cm. And at last, we will place the object at infinity. When the object is placed at infinity, then the two parallels will come and reflect at the concave mirror, which makes an angle with the principal axis and will intersect at focal plane and form an image which will be real, inverted and highly diminished image. So when the object is at infinity, then real, inverted and highly diminished image is formed at focus. When the object is at focus, then highly magnified image is formed at infinity. While studying the object and images formed in the mirror, we must be clear about one thing. Virtual image is that image which is always erect and will be pointed upward. which is formed above the principal axis. This is the principal axis, and virtual image will always be formed above the principal axis, and arrowhead will be pointing upward, whereas the real image is always inverted and will be formed below the principal axis. So we can easily understand by seeing the arrowhead. If the arrowhead points upward and the image is formed above principal axis, then that image is virtual image. Whereas if an image is formed below principal axis and the arrow points downward, then it is real image. Another thing must be made clear here, that while drawing the ray diagrams, we will get the image of A as A1 by intersection of two rays, and then we will draw perpendicular of it to the principal axis, and then we will get the complete image as A1 and B1. This is because the ray of light from bottom of B of the object will travel along the principal axis and will be reflected back along the same path, making angle of incident is equal to angle of reflection is equal to 0. So we will not take the ray of light from B position. We will only take ray of light from A position and get image as A1, and then we will draw perpendicular to it, and we will get the complete images A1 and B1. Now we will study the cases one by one. Case 1, when the object is placed within the focus or within the focal length. Say an object is placed here. Then we will take two ray diagrams. A ray of light parallel to the principal axis will reflect and pass through the focus of the concave mirror. Another ray of light will pass through the center of curvature and will be reflected along the same path. These two reflected ray will never meet this side of the mirror. So if we produce this reflected ray backward, then we will see that they will intersect at a point behind the mirror. This is the image of the object AB. This is virtual, erect and magnified. If we place our eye here, then it will be seen that the ray of light are coming from this point. Here no intersection takes place actually. So it is a virtual image and cannot be obtained on a screen. We can see the image only when we see into the concave mirror. So this is the case 1, when object is placed within the focus, then we will get virtual, erect and magnified image behind the mirror. Now we will take case 2, when the object is placed at focus. We will take two ray of light, one parallel to the principal axis, which will be reflected and pass through the focus. Another ray of light which passes through center of curvature. This ray of light will be reflected back along the same path. Then the reflected rays are parallel to each other, which will form an image at infinity, far away from the mirror, which gonna be drawn by this ray diagram. So when the object is placed as focus, then real, inverted and highly magnified image will be formed at infinity. Case 3, when the object is placed between focus and center of curvature, then we will see where the image is formed and the characteristic of the image. We will take two rays of light, one going parallel to the principal axis, after reflection will pass through the focus of the mirror. Another the ray of light passing through the center of curvature will be reflected back along the same path. If we extend backward, we will see that two reflected rays light, this and this, will meet at the point and will form an image which is real, inverted and magnified, and is formed beyond C. Thus, when an object is placed between focus and center of curvature, then image will be formed beyond C, which will be real, inverted and magnified or enlarged, and beyond center of curvature, beyond C. Now we will study case 4, when object is placed at center of curvature. So when object is placed here at center of curvature, we will take two rays of light, one going parallel to the principal axis will be reflected and pass through the focus. The second ray of light, which we usually take in all other cases, a ray of light passing through the center of curvature will be reflected back along the same path, that is along the center of curvature, cannot be taken here because the object is placed at center of curvature. So we will use rule number 3, a ray of light passing through the focus will be reflected here by the mirror and will become parallel to the principal axis. Now we will study case number 5. In case number 5, we will place an object beyond C, that is beyond center of curvature. Here also we will take 2 rays of light, one going parallel to the principal axis, after reflection will pass through the focus of the concave mirror, another passing through the center of curvature. So these 2 reflected rays meet here, and thus image A1 is formed. If we draw perpendicular from here to the principal axis, we get a complete image A1 B1. Thus we can see that when an object is placed beyond C or center of curvature, then image will be formed between center of curvature and focus, which will be real inverted. Real images are always inverted and virtual images are always erect. Real, inverted, diminished and formed between focus and center of curvature. Now we will study case number 6. In case 6, an object will be placed at infinity, which is far away from the mirror. Suppose 2 rays of light coming from point A are parallel to one another but are at angle to the principal axis. These 2 rays of light are coming from point A of the object placed at infinity. These are 2 parallel rays of light and then will be reflected back. So the image will be formed at the focal length. Thus we can see that when an object is placed at infinity, then its image will be formed at focus, which will be real, inverted and highly diminished. Real, inverted, highly diminished, and it is formed at focal length or at focus. Concave mirror are also known as converging mirror. In our next video, we will study the images formed by convex mirror or diverging mirror. Thank you for watching my video, and if you find my video useful, please do like and share my videos and subscribe my channel to get the latest update of my videos. And if you have any doubt regarding this topic, comment below. I will try to answer as early as possible.